So now we are going to perform an experiment to determine the bleeding time and the clotting time. Coming to the bleeding time, which is the definition of bleeding time is time taken between puncture of the blood vessel and the stoppage of bleeding. And the method that we'll be using for determining the bleeding time is Duke's method. So the apparatus required is cotton, spirit, of course for taking the prick, capillary tube, this is for the clotting time, and filter paper for the bleeding time. So now we'll be starting off with the experiment to determine the bleeding time. So we'll first sterilize the finger. Next, we'll let the spirit dry a bit so that it does not get mixed with the blood. So now we'll proceed with the prick. So first drop is the 0 second drop. You have to make sure that we don't squeeze our finger, and at intervals of 30 seconds we have to put a drop on the filter paper and stop when we see no drop on the filter paper. So now as we can see that there's no drop on the filter paper after 2 minutes. This was on 0 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute, 1 minute, 30 seconds, and on 2 minutes since there is no drop. So the final conclusion is that the bleeding time is 2 minutes by Duke's method. So now we'll proceed with the second part of the experiment, which is estimation of clotting time. So for this we'll need capillary tube to fill the blood. So the basic procedure will be filling this capillary tube with first taking the prick, filling this capillary tube with the blood, and then waiting for 1 minute, and then after 1 minute, at intervals of 15 seconds, we have to break 1 centimeter of this tube. And till the formation of fibrin threads, which will be visible, which will be shown ahead, we have to keep breaking and notice the time on the stopwatch. So first we'll sterilize the finger. We'll let the spirit dry, and then take a prick. So we have started the zero time, we have started the stopwatch, and now we are filling the capillary with blood. And so now we have filled this till 1 minute. Now we'll keep this till 1 minute and then start breaking 1 centimeter of this tube at intervals of 15 seconds. 1 centimeter of this tube. And now we can see there's no formation of fibrin. So we'll wait for another 15 seconds. Still there's no formation of fibrin. We'll continue this till there is formation of a fibrin thread. still there's no formation of fibrin. Still no fibrin. So here we can see the formation of fibrin, because of which this tube is not getting separated from this part. So this is the fibrin.
Yes, very good.
So the coagulation time we got is 4 minutes 35 seconds,
mm-hmm.
which lies in the normal range of 3 to 8 minutes.
Now we will be starting with the discussion part. So the first question is, what is the mechanism of hemostasis?
So the mechanisms of hemostasis include vascular spasm, platelet plaque formation and coagulation.
Okay, the next question is, what are the conditions in which bleeding time is prolonged?
So bleeding time is prolonged in thrombocytopenic purpura because there is deficiency in platelet and hence bleeding time is prolonged.
Name the conditions in which coagulation time is prolonged.
So coagulation time is prolonged in vitamin K deficiency because vitamin K is required for the formation of proteins which are required in coagulation in liver diseases such as cirrhosis and hepatitis, because formation of proteins takes place in liver, and then in classical hemophilia, because in classical hemophilia there is deficiency of factor 8, which is a very important component of the mechanism of coagulation, and the third is the Christmas disease in which there is deficiency in factor 9.
Okay, the next question is, why coagulation time is more than bleeding time?
Coagulation time is more than bleeding time because coagulation involves the interaction of a lot of factors which include coagulation factors and the components of the blood, whereas bleeding time is just a mechanical process.
Okay, the next question is, name the different laboratory anticoagulants and state their actions.
EDTA, oxalate and citrate, these combine with calcium and reduce their levels in blood and hence prevent the process of coagulation. And heparin inhibits thrombin. The action of thrombin is converting fibrinogen to fibrin. So if heparin is inhibiting thrombin, the conversion of fibrinogen to fibrin will be affected, and hence there will be and hence the process of coagulation won't take place.
Thank you for watching.